Graz. 10 years ago, this Austrian city was named Europe's cultural capital. Since then, Graz has established itself as a major European city, and not only in cultural terms. Graz has recently become a stronghold of medical research and development in Europe. The holy grail is personalised medicine. The origins of this success story lead us first from the heights of a castle to the depths of the darkest cellars. In these hallways of the Medical University of Graz, pathologists started to examine and archive human tissue many years ago. This is how Europe's largest biobank was created. Today, the collection comprises over 6 million pathological samples. So what is the link between a biobank with its historical tissue samples and the medicine of the future?
Wir sammeln die Proben von Kranken.
We collect the samples from sick people, patients and subjects who come to us voluntarily to provide us with their samples. We store those samples and provide them to scientists in the hope of making progress in identifying and understanding illnesses and developing therapies, early warning systems, therapeutics and pharmaceutical products.
One of these scientists is Professor Dr. Kurt Satlukar. The analysis of biobank samples enables the pathologist to identify the molecular cause of a specific illness that makes it unique. This is the key to his field of research.
Personalized medicine is about optimizing the pharmaceutical drugs for individual patients and the specific requirements of their illness. Necessary, because many illnesses are much more individual and heterogeneous. This also means that there will be fewer pharmaceuticals suitable for a large group of patients. We need medicine adapted to the specific needs of an individual human being. This might sound simple, but is in fact a huge scientific challenge. We're faced with a really complex situation here.
What makes this science so complex at times is the data processing work involved. Vast quantities of genetic data are generated and then have to be gathered and analyzed. That is why Professor Zatlukal works closely with the computer scientist and mathematician Dr. Heimo Müller. Together, they have developed a model which makes it possible to compare patient data.
Here we have the progress of individual patients out of a group of over 5,000 with colorectal cancer. These are all the different stages of the tumor with their prognosis. This enables us to follow the way in which the treatment has affected the illness. These patients here, can we have a closer look at this? The color of these cubes, of these symbols, indicate the stage of the tumor at the time of the surgery. Here, for example, you can see patients who've been operated in a very early stage of the tumor, but have nevertheless died from the illness within the space of a few months. You can see this by looking at the height and the color of the cubes. Black means that they have died. By comparing these, you can see that this patient here would probably not benefit from another therapy, whereas this patient would have urgently needed a therapy to help improve his prognosis.
Patents play a major part in the development of such important systems. Certain elements of this modeling were also patented. The statistics show that this field of research, personalized medicine, is gradually becoming more important. Although most of the current patents are American, Europe, and the city of Graz in particular, has always been one of the most important places for this research area.
100 years ago, when this clinical center was built, we celebrated those 100 years last year, it was the largest in Europe.
A few years after the opening, Austria became a really small country. This meant that there was a huge clinical center for a very small area. Consequently, wherever a patient sample was obtained or a tumor was operated, all of the patients were examined in one single institute. This material was gathered systematically over the course of many years, so that we now have one of the largest collections of human specimens in the world. This collection represents a large spectrum of human illnesses. Historically, this is an almost unique situation.
Und das ist historisch fast eine einzigartige Situation.
But the University Clinic of Graz stood out not just for its physical size, it was also patronized by great minds that later went down in history.
This is Rocky Tansky, a pathologist who strongly influenced the development of Austrian pathology. Rocky Tansky tried to understand the illness of one single organ in the context of the whole organism, and this approach was the key for the next generation of personalized medicine. When we try to classify illnesses based on the underlying disease mechanism rather than on the affected organ, a whole new range of possible classifications appear. That means that all the medical books would have to be rewritten. It's a medical revolution.
Es ist eine Revolution in der Medizin.
Maybe it is this revolutionary side of personalized medicine that led to its large acceptance in the population. At first, this may seem surprising. After all, it is the human genome which is researched here. But is our acceptance also unlimited? How far can personalized medicine go? And what will this mean?
What is very interesting is that currently, personalized medicine mainly focuses on the therapy of advanced diseases. In the future, though, we'll need personalized medicine in prevention as well. Disease prevention has to be as individualized as therapy. I think it's important to accept that people will cope very differently with the possibility of risk forecasting. The more we learn about biological processes and disease processes, the more we understand how difficult and complex biology and life itself are, and the more our respect grows for all of what lies beneath.